What's going on, guys? It's Helios, or as you can call me, Hagen. And in today's video, we're going to be doing the ultimate guide to the new Call of Duty Zombies map, The Machine. Now, this is not going to be an Easter egg guide by any means necessary. This is just going to be the bare bones basics of what you're going to need to high round and to do the Easter egg. Because as of recording this video, the Easter egg has not been solved yet and it hasn't even been unlocked. Now, with that out of the way, let's go ahead and get into this guide. All right, so the first thing I'm going to be showing you guys today is going to be how to turn on power in the map. Now, if you follow the route that I am showing you on screen right now, this is going to take you directly to the bunker that's going to lead to power. So you're going to get out of the actual Nocturne Totem into this open plane crash field, and you're going to go past Jug into this bunker. Now, once you're in the bunker, it's actually going to be pretty hectic because there's going to be a lot of zombies that are going to come after you, so you just had to head down into this two crossroads. And I always go to the right just because right is right. And so you're just going to keep opening all these doors, heading all the way down. They're going to be about 1,500 each, so it's a lot of points. You just have to keep going down into this bunker. Now, once you're towards the bottom of the bunker, it's actually going to show you this icon on screen that shows power. So just go towards this icon, and it's actually going to show you where to go. You're just going to buy the door and hit the switch. Now, you're not done yet. You need to hit two terminals within the bottom of the bunker in the power room to complete the dark ether portal. So there's going to be one terminal right here. And if you follow the way that I'm going on screen right now, you're going to find the other terminal is also highlighted on your screen. And that's how you turn on power in this map, guys. So next, I'm going to show you is how to pack a punch in this map. So you have to turn on power, of course, and then you're going to enter the dark ether through this portal that you just created by turning on power. Now you're going to have this teleporting animation. This part's actually fairly easy, so all you have to do is go to the tunnel that is highlighted on your screen. There's a little icon that shows up, and all you have to do is go to the Aether Tunnel, and you're going to find the tunnel. It's basically a fast travel, and you're going to use the fast travel to find the Pack-a-Punch part and add it to the machine. If you end up getting the same Aether Tunnel as me, because I do believe they change each game, this is going to be the route that I took to get to the tunnel. So once you take the tunnel, it's going to have this small fast travel animation, and right behind where you spawn in is going to be the Pack-a-Punch part. So you're just going to take that all the way back down to the bottom of the bunker where the portal was, and it's going to actually make the Pack-a-Punch machine, and it's going to teleport you back into the regular world. Now, once you're back in the regular world, it's going to ask you if you want a Pack-a-Punch. And now, Pack-a-Punch has actually changed this year, guys. So you actually have three levels of Pack-a-Punch, tier 1, 2, and 3. Tier 1 is just going to be the regular Pack-a-Punch price, and it's going to be a lot of damage. Whereas tier 2 is going to be 15,000 points, and it's going to be a lot more damage, and the Pack-a-Punch camo is going to change. And finally, there's going to be tier 3, which is going to be the most expensive, and it's going to be 30,000 points, and it's going to be the most powerful version that you can get of your gun at this time. As well as Pack-a-Punching, you can actually add new ammo mods, which is not new to Call of Duty Zombies. We had it in BO3 and in Black Ops 4. This is going to be four different ammo mods called Napalm Burst, Deadwire, Cryo Freeze, and Brain Rot. And those are all going to be upgradable weapon mods that you can use on any gun that you Pack-a-Punch. You can even use these mods on guns that you don't Pack-a-Punch. You just have to have enough points to do so. So the next guide, I'm going to show you guys where all the perk locations are. So if you start from spawn, head into Nocturne Totem, and go all the way to the top of the actual building, you're going to run into the first perk on our guide, and it's going to be stamina. Now if you head from Nocturne Totem to the open airfield, you're going to see Jug right in the middle of the field. And if you head into the bottom of the bunker, you're going to actually run into our next perks. Now, there's going to be two different ones. So if you go to the right, you're going to head to our first perk, and it's going to be a Deadshot. Now, Deadshot's all the way at the bottom of this little nuke building. As you can see in my gameplay, I take you all the way to the bottom, and it's going to be right there. Now, if you head back towards spawn, you're actually going to go all the way in the back. There's going to be a bunker open since you turned on power. Go all the way down, and there's going to be Elemental Pop right there. Now, if you head all the way to back where Jug is and you go up on the wing all the way into the back of the pond area, you're going to find Quick Revive just chilling all the way in the back. And it's actually going to heal you faster and heal your teammates faster. Now, if you go back towards the bunker, you're actually going to go to the left this time, which is going to take us to our next perk, which is going to be Speed Cola. And it's just going to be right here in the middle of the room. the last perk location is actually going to be on top of Nocturne Totem, but it's only going to be in the Dark Aether mode. It's going to be at the very top right here on the right. And the cool thing about this Wunderfizz is that you can actually choose which perks you are going to get. And that's going to be it for our perk guides, ladies and gentlemen. So next guide I'm going to show you guys is how to get shield on the map, because it is essential for the map. So if you take from the speed cola room and you go all the way to the right, there's going to be this armor stand right here. And it's actually going to show you three different types of armor that you can actually use. It's going to be tier 1, 2, and 3. Now each tier respectively is going to add more armor. So tier 1 is just going to be one armor plate. Tier 2 is going to be 2. And obviously tier 3 is going to be 3. And you can replenish this armor at any time as long as you have salvage that you pick up from zombies. So as well as having armor, we also have new tier upgrades for our weapons. And it's going to be tier 2, tier 3, and tier 4, and tier 5. Now these are actually going to be the different rarities that we have in the game. It's going to be green, blue, purple, and then gold. Alright, for the last guide, I'm actually just going to show you guys a showcase of the new Wonder Weapon called the Dai Shockwave. It's actually a really intense and a really new gun that actually sucks up zombies to get ammo and shoots a shockwave of energy out, much like what the Jekken should have been on Black Ops 2. Now, there's actually only two ways that you could end up acquiring this weapon. It's actually through the mystery box or through the legendary challenges. Now, I spent a couple hours trying to get this out of the challenges and it just never happened. So just keep in mind, if you keep your legendary challenges, you could actually end up getting the Dai Shockwave as a reward. You could get really lucky and get it out of the box just like I did in this gameplay. Now for the rest of the video, I just thought I'd show you guys how the Wonder Weapon works. And so with all the guides out of the way, guys, I'm just wanted to say thank you so much for watching the video. If you did enjoy, if you could drop a like, that'd be greatly appreciated. Subscribe if you're new, turn on those post notifications, that way you guys never miss an upload, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.